Everything's upgrading now. Computers is upgrading. Technology is upgrading. I know in the New Year's resolution, when it become New Year's, I know a lot of folk are going to say that my New Year's resolution is to get rich. I don't mind getting rich, but somebody may say, well, my New Year's resolution is to get a new house and a new car. All those things are great. There's nothing wrong with that. But my New Year's resolution is to live holy. You can't just say amen to somebody. My New Year's resolution is preparing myself to meet Jesus when he comes back. Because we can have all those things, but if your soul is not saved, money's not going to buy you into heaven. Can you say amen to somebody? Money's not going to save us out of hell. Jesus said in the book of Mark chapter 8 verse 36, what profits a man if he gain the whole world and lose his soul? And that's wrong getting rich. But like everything is upgrading, but it's like folk is not ready to serve the Lord. They have all these upgrades with the computer, technology, all that stuff. The scientists is upgrading, but they don't want to repent. Don't want to be born again. But Jesus said, my word is going to live forever. And when all these computers go down, when the car breaks down, when the house breaks down, God's word will never break down. Can you say amen to somebody? Because he's the one we all going to stand before. He's the one that's going to judge us. He is the righteous judge. Let's go to the book of Joshua, chapter 7. Joshua, chapter 7. We're going to go to verse number 12. We thank God for the souls that came to Jesus Christ here in the Bronx. We had a service on Willis Avenue, and drug addicts came to Christ. Dope addicts came to Jesus. Somebody's tired of being on drugs. Somebody's tired of being on dope. God is a great hope. Now we're right here on St. Anne, Brook Avenue, 141st Street. Let's go to the book of Joshua, chapter 7. Let's go to verse number 12. Therefore, the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turned their backs before their enemies, because they were a curse. Neither will I be with you anymore, except ye destroy the accursed from among you. Praise the Lord. We're going to read the rest of the chapters later on. I want you to tell your neighbor, begin to say, neighbor, this monkey got to go. This monkey got to go. This is my title today. This monkey got to go. Here in the book of Joshua, chapter number 7, we know Israel was God's first chosen people, and they're still God's first chosen people. Joshua was a succeeder of Moses. You know who Moses was. That was the one that God gave the commandments on Mount Sinai. We all know the story of the Ten Commandments. Actually, it was 613 commandments that God gave Moses on Mount Sinai. But we just talk about the Ten Commandments. But actually, in the Torah, in the Hebrew Bible, it's called the Torah, which means the law of life. It was actually 613 commandments. And after God finished using Moses, God rose up Joshua, who was the helper of Moses. He was a successor of Moses. And here God began to lead Israel. When God finished with one man of God, God always got another man of God he raises up. Can you say amen to somebody? God never runs out of servants. And all the heathen nations was afraid of Israel because they knew that God was with Israel. So they knew not to mess with Israel. Tell someone, don't mess with me. Praise God. So every time someone messed with Israel, God messed with them. So every war they fought, they always won victories because God was the one that won victories for Israel. Praise God for the victory. Tell someone, thank God for the victory. But this particular time, Israel lost in a particular war. They fought against the men of Ai. Here in the book of Joshua chapter 7, if you read verse 1, you get a chance to. In verse 2, they fought against an army called Ai, and they lost. So Joshua was like, wait a minute, I don't understand. We used to winning wars. He prayed to God and said, Lord, why did we lose this war? Why did we lose this war, God? And God began to come to Joshua and say, Joshua, the reason why I did not win this war for you this time and for Israel, my people, because there was an accursed thing that was in the camp. There was something evil that was in the camp. Now, someone said, how did that evil get in the camp? Well, the Bible said that the son of Carmi, his name was Achan, the son of Carmi. The Bible said he took of the accursed thing. The Bible said he stole Babylonian garments. Now, you know God is against Babylon. Babylon is wicked. Babylon is evil. So now one of God's people in Israel stole Babylonian garments and hid it in the tent. Now, he thought he can hide this stuff from God, but we know God see everything, right? God see all things. So now, Joshua and Israel couldn't understand why they lost this particular war against this heathen army. One man's sin caused God not to win that war. That's deep. Because there was an evil thing that was in the camp. The Bible said right here. So as we go back to Joshua, you understand what I'm talking about so far? So the Bible said it here in verse 12. Therefore, the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turned their backs before their enemies because they were what? Accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except, someone say except, he destroy the curse from among you. That was a monkey. That was a demonic monkey. Sometimes we got different demonic monkeys like statues in our house. I preached about that before, our idols in our house, and now it brings demonic spirits. That's the accursed thing. Many people have asked me, they say, oh, Apostle Warren, can you pray for me? I can't understand why all these bad things are happening to my children. Do you not know that when your children are watching these violent movies, that's an accursed thing, amen, somebody? Do you not know that when your children are watching these demonic video games, that's a monkey? That's an accursed thing? Someone said, get rid of the monkey. Just tell someone, this monkey got to go. There's certain things that people got in their house that opened up doors for demons. Me and the woman of God were talking about this last night. You know they got folk that got Ouija boards in their house? We talked about that before. Ouija boards are demonic. Have you ever heard of Ouija boards before? And Ouija boards, they got Ouija boards. The Ouija boards, they use to contact the spirits of the dead. You go down and see tarot cards. That's an accursed thing. That's a demonic monkey. And you'd be surprised how many church people who don't even know that stuff is of the devil. Because when you get in trouble, instead of them calling on Jesus, they run down to the tarot card reader. They run down to the witch doctor, not knowing that's a monkey. Can you say amen to someone? Tell someone, this monkey got to go. That's an accursed thing because witch doctors doesn't serve Jesus. They serve demons. So what happens is when people got these Ouija boards in their house and their tarot cards up in their house and they got these demonic movies, do you know there's certain movies I had to throw away? Because it was causing me to have nightmares in my house. I was getting all these nightmares. Didn't realize God should throw this movie away. Throw that movie away. Some of these horror movies. Hello, somebody. You know what I'm talking about. I used to like to watch these horror movies. I don't like to watch them now. Tales of the Crypt. Remember that? Frankenstein. That's a whole creature there. Yeah. Dracula, Count Dracula. And they had this new demonic guy. Who? Freddy Krueger. Yeah, yep. Oh, he's crazy. You guess who's crazy is? R. Jason from Friday the 13th. Can you say amen to somebody? Yeah, right. So when you watch that stuff, before you know it, when you watch that stuff, now you're getting all these violent thoughts. Oh, another one, Michael Myers. Remember Michael Myers? He gets as crazy as Jason, both of them going to hell. Can you say amen to somebody? Amen. So when people don't realize when they watch these demonic movies, they open up doors for demons. Now you're having all these nightmares, all these bad things are happening. Now your finances are getting cursed. You can't sleep at night. All of a sudden you're having problems on your job because demons follow. Am I teaching right? Because them spirits jump from the movies right into your house. Do you know what that, what's that demonic movie I had years ago? It was called Exorcist. Remember Exorcist? Yeah. That was a crazy, scary movie. That movie was scary, wasn't it? You remember Exorcist, right? She had to spit in her head and spit out all this green throw up. Why would a little girl want to play a part like that? That movie was scary. Do you not know? Am I telling the truth here? That's thank you. That was an accursed thing. Thank you. That was a monkey. Someone said this monkey. Tell someone this monkey got to go. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'll put it right here. Thank you. You're such a help. Praise God. Clap your hand for Jesus Christ over here. Thank you for helping me. Let me go to Paul.